You are an immortal being having a spiritual existence. Deepak Chopra.
To expand upon the words of Deepak Chopra, you are in fact a multidimensional being existing on many planes of existence simultaneously. If your mind is a bit blown, you're not alone. It's challenging to wrap your third dimensional brain around such concepts. Even noted brainiacs like Neil deGrasse Tyson have said as much. But we've got the Akashic Records guides and angels on our sides. In this video, they're going to explain multidimensionality so we may all understand and have more appreciation for our beingness.
I've read that when we incarnate, only 10% of our soul's energy does so, while the rest is at the higher self level. What does the higher self do while our 10% is down here? Does it interact with other higher selves? Does it still learn lessons while up there? What happens to the higher self of people who die and become earthbound because they were too afraid of going into the light of home or because they died in such a way that their soul stayed stuck? This is so intriguing to me.
Well, that is a fascinating question. So without further ado, here is what the Akashic guides had to say. You are trying to assign a finite measurement to energy, which is infinite. Your soul is multidimensional, existing on many planes simultaneously. There is a ceaseless ebb and flow of energy, more flowing where it is needed, and subsequently ebbing when less concentrated focus is required. Your energy joins with other souls for co-creating on any dimensional plane. It also expands into new areas as you expand and evolve. Your soul is a marvel of efficiency, and like a finely tuned instrument, performs at ever higher levels of exquisiteness as your frequency rises. So you see, it's not a matter of what your soul does in the higher realms. Your soul is unlimited and ever expanding. What doesn't it do might be a better way of looking at things. Yes, there's a great deal of interaction with other souls. In your thousands of lifetimes, you have formed bonds with a great many others. So there's catching up, reminiscing, simply enjoying one another's company, planning for the future, a healthy dose of leisure activities, because souls often engage in activities they enjoyed while incarnated, and their soul school, where you may pursue any area of study that interests you. That's just a partial list, of course. Souls who remain stuck on the earthly plane are choosing to throw out a metaphorical boat anchor, tethering a part of themselves, because for whatever reason, they're not ready to completely relinquish this particular incarnation. By this choice, future incarnations are placed on hold. However, the rules still apply with regard to their activities in other dimensions. They're somewhat like a broken record that skips back to the same spot over and over until someone or something gives them a nudge forward. Do not worry overly much about them. They may choose to move forward anytime they wish. Their journey, their choice. It's a fine question, and we salute you for bringing the matter to the forefront for others to consider. Well, there you have it. That's the answer. I hope that satisfies your question, Louise, and the rest of you out there. If you have more questions, please leave them in the comments below. I'd be delighted to take them to the guides and get you more answers. If you've enjoyed this video, please like, share, subscribe. It all helps. My mission is to share the wisdom of the Akashic Records with as many people as possible so that we might bring on the transformation of Earth as we move into the great shift. But I can't do it alone. I need your help. Every one of you is deeply appreciated. Thank you for all that you have done and all that you will do. Till next time, this is Debbra Lupien, voice of the Akashic Records.